about it right now with the man who's on the other side of the football.
Yeah, teammate of his, Shaq Barrett, now joins the show. Shaq, thanks so much for the time this morning. How are you?
I'm doing good. Thanks for having me on.
Shaq, we miss you in Denver, bro. Thanks for taking a few minutes, and we're happy for you. We honestly are. You really bet on yourself when you left here, and now you got a chance to win a freaking Super Bowl. Has that hit home yet?
Yeah. I'm like in the middle of it all processing right now, but yeah, it's just crazy to be in a situation that I am now. It is still surreal a little bit.
You know, Shaq, you look back to your time with the Broncos in Super Bowl 50. You were such a young guy, undrafted in 14, coming out and so on. You are a huge, huge part of why the Buccaneers are there on the defensive side of the football. Is it maybe more satisfying now as a huge integral part of that team to get to the ultimate and opportunity to win it, knowing that you contributed so extensively to it?
Yeah, it's a little bit. Well, a Super Bowl is a Super Bowl. Like, as long as I got in a game in Denver and I do feel like I did something, it still was super satisfying. But now that I am like one of the guys, now it will be a little bit more satisfying. Help will a team to a championship. Yeah, just being in this position where I'm actually contributing, it means a lot.
Well, Shaq, another part of this. Did you guys feel a little bit of disrespect at the beginning of the year? Because your front seven is unbelievable between you and Sue and JPP and Levante David and Devin White. Like, did you guys feel disrespect heading into this season defensively?
I mean, it's been since last year, like the disrespect, and it just continued. And we just don't even think about it or talk about it no more. We know what we mean to our team. We know what we bring. And we're going to do it game in and game out. It was just the matter of having more wins and going to the playoffs. That's the only reason why we were disrespected, because it wasn't necessarily translating into wins.
Shaq, you were here when Peyton changed the culture. What did Tom Brady do to Tampa? Can you put a finger on what he's done to change the culture down there?
Not specifically, but there's a lot of stuff that he's been doing. Just like, first of all, just being here, being Tom Brady, being himself, talking to every guy on the team, from the top man on the roster to the 53rd man on the roster, just his personality, it just what he bring on the field. You know, everybody know what he bring on the field. So just that, along with everybody's willingness to buy in and to learn and to be better and to become the better pros, and just to know that we could learn from each other, just that willingness is just all accumulating into the season we have right now.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing, and I guess that helps when you go on the road. Shaq, I can't believe it. You're 11-5, but you got to go on the road. You go on the road to Washington and win. You go on the road to New Orleans and win. Then you got to go to Lambeau and win the dang football game, and you do all of that. What's this road warrior mentality that you guys have had, really from the time the postseason started?
We just, like, We don't even care who we playing. We would have loved to be home, but like home field advantage, like you said, wasn't too much of a difference this year. Even though Lambeau was pretty loud, we just got to get it done. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. It's like no excuses. We in a position that we wanted to be in at the beginning of the year to control our destiny, and all we had to do is outplay the team, make them. Well, hopefully they make a little bit more mistakes than we made. It just be a Simon sound for the most part, and that's what happened. We had players step up at the right time, make the big plays. We tried to be a Simon sound, and now it's just all paying off. We just got to keep doing it for one more game, and we'll be in ultimate position.
Shaq Barrett with us, Tampa Bay Buccaneer. Shaq, you've played all these road games in the postseason, and now you're the first team ever to play a home game in the Super Bowl. What's that like? I mean, I know it's different for teams that, you know, everybody plays a Super Bowl on the road, but for you guys, you're staying home. So what's the process there?
Yeah, it is different for sure, but it's not like – it's a good different, though. I'm happy we don't have to leave, especially with COVID. I'm happy we don't have to leave a whole week early to travel to another city and be away from my family and stuff like that. But it is just amazing to be in a hometown playing the Super Bowl. Like, it's no better feeling than, like, to be at the practice field last week, seeing all the Super Bowl stuff go up. Because, like, you got an open, clear line of sight from our practice field to the stadium. So it was just extra motivation during the week. Last week, it's just, like, just everything is just working perfectly and coming together perfect. Like, we got to finish it. Like, we come this far just to come this far.
Dude, Super Bowl's special because your family gets involved. You give tickets to people, but how many family members can go? How many tickets have you gotten for your people?
This year it sucks with COVID. Most definitely does. I have 8 tickets right now. I've been trying to get some more, but haven't been lucky enough to get more yet. But I'm trying to come up on a couple more tickets, but right now we have a total of 8 that we could get.
Yeah, at least you're going to be able to get people in the building, though, and that's a positive thing. Shaq, before we let you go, we certainly appreciate your time. I know a lot of Rams Nation right now is listening in. They love to hear from you. You're going up against a guy that you know all about. I mean, a guy who's just simply one of the best, if not the best in the game right now, in Patrick Mahomes. I don't give away game plans, but what do you have to do to try and just slow those guys down? Because we know the kind of talent they have.
The best thing we can do is try to keep Mahomes in a pocket and don't just let him outplay us with his playmaking compared to our playmaking, because we're going to have chances to get him down. And he usually make plays to make you miss or something like that. So it's going to be up to us to finish the playoff and not let him extend and turn a sack into a 50-yard game, 40-yard game.
Huh. Shaq, we don't get the chance very often to talk to somebody who plays with Tom Brady, and we've discussed this a lot on the show. Post-game food spread comes in. What does Tom Brady eat?
I said, I'll never see him because I don't go to the meal room that often after the game, but I'm pretty sure he eat what everybody else eat, though.
He may not eat. He may be a robot, man. Hey, dude, we are rooting for you from afar. We really are. You've been a class act all this time. You go to Tampa, and here you are in the bowl again. Best of luck to you next week, man.
I appreciate it, and I miss you guys back there as well, man.
All right, man. Shaq,
go get him, Shaq. Go get him.
Former Bronco. Thanks, Todd, for setting that up. Appreciate that. Todd Romero, his buddy.